Liz Roberts is the head of production here.
Oh, Liz, you're wonderful, said Sonia Poulton.
Well, Liz Roberts is a production expert going back through a long career in the mainstream. She's been with us for a few months.
Award-winning documentaries.
Yeah, award-winning. Yeah, absolutely. She's fantastic. Yeah. And the reason she's here...
Worn a T-shirt.
The reason that Liz is here on a fraction of what she could get in the mainstream, and I tell you it's a fraction, is because she supports deeply what we're doing. So now she's had to go away from all the other stuff that needs doing to get the figures together. And in the next 2 days, depends how long it takes her, then all that will be published in terms of in and out from day one to now. And we're doing it because Ms. Poulton is seeking to do as much damage as she can to the people's voice. And we just have to counter that with the truth and the facts. So that is what is going on now. And those figures will be published. No problem whatsoever. Another question that people are asking is why the People's Voice is not set up as a
not-for-profit organization.
Foundation or a trust.
Yeah, trust, yeah, yeah.
And I have actually answered this question before, but I'll do it again. The idea was to make it a not-for-profit trust or foundation for one simple reason. All the tax benefits and all the benefits in local council taxation that you get if you're in that situation. It would have saved us so much money had we been able to do that. So we went to accountants in the early days and said, look, we want to be a non-profit trust or foundation. Can you set it up? And they came back to us and they said, look, mate, we can, but the rules and regulations are that if you do take that status, you've got to be non-political and you can't criticize the government, basically. Well, What were we set up to do? So we have been left with the worst of both worlds. The only way the company could exist and put out the output that we do was to be a private limited company. And that means that we have the worst of both worlds in the sense of we are not for profit. There is no shareholders, there's only Sean as a director anyway, there's no shareholders going to get any money, but we get none of the benefits of being a not-for-profit foundation. So that was a killer to us, and it's obviously meant that there's been more potential expenditure than there would have been had we got what we wanted. So that's what that is. And of course, every year, by law, accounts are published. We've not gone through our first year yet. But we're going early with Liz anyway and saying, okay, here you go. But it will be clear on any annual accounts where the money went. And not one single penny will go to any shareholder. Like I say, the only director is Sean. And so we're left with this situation where someone who, right up to making the allegations, was saying nothing, who was telling everybody how fantastic this organization was, what a fantastic and vital job it was doing, how great the people working here are, how great I was, how great Sean was, how great Liz Roberts was. Didn't say how great you were, but we know the background there. And then suddenly, when something happens she don't like, out of nowhere comes all this nonsense, including, I mean, please, the fact that when we wanted to meet her, we met her about her behavior on the Monday, that we took her into this dark room with these chairs.
Where is that room?
Well,
I've never
the
seen
dark this. Room. Well, this is a good example of just how pathetic her statements is. You know that during the day, this place is pretty much packed now because of all the interest.
Yeah. Yeah.
So every single room and office had people in it doing something. Did she want us to talk to her in private or in front of everybody? The one room that was free and empty was the room where we shoot the band. The band studio. Anyone seen the band? Well, I've seen that. See the telethon, you'll see it. The band studio, as my mother used to say, has no big light. It has no main light. Why? It's not necessary. Because it's where bands play and comedians perform. And if you watch the band, it's always dark. Why? Because it's lit for that. So that's the darkened room. I mean, it's like dealing with a child. And I'll say this finally. Does it say something, or what does it say, that when Sonia Poulton stormed out of here on the Monday morning, her whole team was there? Her whole team shook their heads, sat down, and are now working with Mark Windows to cover that slot from next week, 5 till 7. Her whole team shook their heads.
Well, and then, that,
well, they did, but let's go into that. Let's say they were relieved, and they are still with us, every single one.
Yeah.
What does that say? So, you know something, mate? In the last 25 years, I've had times, many, many times, when I thought I couldn't go on anymore and I didn't see the point, because I despaired at the human race and I despaired at the way they behaved and how they were watching their own prison being created around them and doing what? Often abusing those that were alerting them to it. And when I've seen the reaction of the Poulton groupies to her ludicrous claims, I despair at the human race and its stupidity and its naivety and its ridiculousness. But
a tiny percentage of the human race, remember.
Yes.
A tiny percentage.
I'm just coming around to that. But there are fantastic numbers of people who can see it and who can see what we're trying to achieve and are intelligent enough to see that to create all this from £300,000 is a miracle. And here we are now looking down the barrel of the end financially, because we're not getting the support we need at the moment. And we are squandering money when we're looking at the end of this station's existence after all that we've done and all we've put in. It's ludicrous. But there are people, vast numbers of people, not the Poulton groupies, who make me despair at the human race. There are people that can see it, decent people, people who've given what they can to help us. That's what I do it for. That's what we all do it for. And Poulton is just a fly on an elephant's back. One other thing. Look at the Indiegogo appeal video. Ms. Poulton is on that. Look what she says when it's played in the days ahead. And that's what she was saying. Right up to out of nowhere, these allegations starting. Pathetic is not the word.
Cheers, mate. We will, of course, extend we will extend the courtesy of an offer of an interview to Sonia Poulton on this program if she wants to make any more or bring any more substance to some of these ridiculous allegations that she's been making. And we were planning, before this system crash we've had today, to open the phones up And if supporters of hers or ours or anybody else wanted to come on and ask questions, I was going to take those questions. We can't do it today, obviously. Hopefully we'll do it on Thursday. So we'll do it on Thursday. Thank you.